Hello friends, welcome to my channel Neurology Videos Learn by Seeing. Today we will learn some important features about headache. What are the cranial structures which are pain sensitive? This is very important question which is asked in Viva. Answer is scalp. Then we have middle meningeal artery, we have dural venous sinuses, we have falx cerebri, and we have the proximal segment of the large pile artery. So remember this thing, that is scalp, middle meningeal artery, dural venous sinuses, falx cerebri, and the proximal segment of large pile arteries. And what are pain insensitive? Remember these two questions which are asked: ventricular ependymoma and choroid plexus. Ventricular ependymoma, choroid plexus, these are pain insensitive. Pile veins and brain parenchyma. Now, what are the two type of headaches? We know that there are two type of headaches: primary headache, secondary headache. Which is a commonest type of headache? Commonest type of headache in community is tension type headache. It is 69%. Then we have migraine, 16%. Then we have idiopathic, exertional, and cluster headache. Which is the commonest type of secondary headache? Answer is systemic infections. That is, it corresponds to 63% of headache. Then we have head injuries, 4%. Vascular disorders, SCH, and brain tumor. Now, what is the history of early morning headache or any nocturnal headache tells you? When a patient complains of early morning headache or nocturnal headache, this is very important. This is alarming because it tells you about increased CSF, that is raised ICT. You always go for brain imaging in this patient because it tells you about Ixol. And if a patient has fever, headache, negligently vomiting, then it tells you about meningitis. Now, if a patient has vomiting that precedes the appearance of headache by weeks, that is, vomiting has started a long time back before headache, it is highly characteristic of posterior fossa brain tumors. If head pain, it appears abrupt. That is, it is positional. Patient has head pain which appears after bending forward, lifting, or coughing. Then always rule out posterior fossa mass, Chiari malformations, and low CSF volume. Okay, we know the one cause of jaw claudication, that is giant cell arteritis, but there are some another causes of jaw claudication, that is vinca alkaloids and common carotid artery blockage. Okay, giant cell arteritis is associated with polymyalgia rheumatica. We know that in temporal arteritis, scalp tenderness is present. Hello friends, welcome to my channel Neurology Videos Learn by Seeing. If you are tuning to this channel first time, subscribe it to get the maximum neurology videos, and do press that bell button to get the notification of each and every video.